This is TWiT.
The iOS world was rocked with scandal this week. New Yorkers expressed public outrage over the unappetizing bagel emoji in iOS 12.1 Beta 2. Now, instead of telling us we were looking at it wrong, Apple decided to change the emoji.
That's nice of them.
Joining us to discuss Bagelgate is emoji expert Jeremy Burge. Now, before we get started, Jeremy, are you also a bagel expert?
I like a bagel, but I've seen too many bagels this week. I have seen more bagels than I needed to in a lifetime.
You've been over OD'd on bagels.
So first of all, did I get all the details correct? Correct me if I got something wrong in the telling of the Bagelgate.
Yeah, I think that's a fair summary. So Apple came out with the second beta of iOS 12.1 about 2 weeks ago now, and it had a bagel. And the most prominent critics of the bagel were the New Yorkers, but there were others. You can see it here that there were complaints about it being too dry, too thick, the texture's not right.
Does look pretty dry.
You know what? I saw some people complaining about the contents, but it was a lot about exactly the style of it. It was too mechanical. It wasn't organic enough. And so this week, Apple, they came out with a new beta of iOS, and I say they fixed it. Some people still don't think so, but that's possibly another story.
Well, so here's my question. What is the bigger sin in the world of bagels? Is it perfect form or is it the exclusion of cream cheese? I want to know what the real problem is here.
You know what? So the feedback that I personally got and that came to Emojipedia, which again, we're not responsible for what Apple does, but I think people, they want to vent somewhere.
Yes, of course.
Full. You know what? I saw some cream cheese fans, but it was really a lot about the texture. I didn't see everybody saying I demand it have cream cheese. They were just complaining that the texture wasn't right. And as a company that we come out with our own sample images each year as well, and we found this one really tough. So I can understand that. I think perhaps Apple figured out they couldn't make the texture look better in an emoji, so they just hit it with the cream cheese. I think that was sort of the way around it.
Well, there was a little more texture added to the bagel. Yeah. It looked less uniform. But
yeah, less perfect.
My question is, how did it get this far? I mean, it was iOS 12.1 beta 2. That's how far it got. 12.1 beta 2. Yep. How did it get so out of hand?
You know what? It's a good emoji, though. It might not be a tasty bagel, but the old one was a good emoji. You could look at that, and no one was confused that it wasn't a bagel. It's just that people have opinions about food, especially East Coast New Yorkers in particular, but anyone likes their food. And now, of course, that Apple's changed it, you start hearing from everybody else. We hear from people that in Montreal that it now doesn't look anything like a Montreal bagel. We hear from the vegans that it's no longer vegan friendly, potentially, depending on the type of cream cheese. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
could be made with
you
cashews.
Can't win, honestly, yeah,
cashew cream cheese is delicious.
I think the solution here, like we've already seen the solution in the world of emoji. We now have all different hair colors. Mm-hmm. For humans. We have all different skin colors for humans, obviously. We need all different bagel types. You know, there could be a sesame, there could be a cheddar, there could be a schmear or a lox. Like, when does the end? When does stop the madness? Seriously.
Hey, can you imagine the argument? Right now, we have one Unicode code point called bagel, and that can look like whatever vendors want it to. Different companies show it different ways. Can you imagine the outcry when only five specific ones are then picked? It's one thing to just say, look, this is up to companies. If you want to draw it with sesame seeds or without it, you can draw it however you like. Can you imagine the arguments then if you have to pick just five specific types?
Oh boy.
If you're the sixth most popular bagel type in the world, yeah. I think you'll make people even more mad.
Yeah, riots in the streets.
I think the Microsoft bagel emoji looks like a cantaloupe with a donut on top of it.
Yeah, it kind of does look like a donut.
Microsoft said they look odd out of context. When you put them next to all the other Windows emoji designs, they look quite good. They all have this thick outline. But when you take them out of context, they do look odd next to the others, I'd have to say.
So some people, I guess, thought that the donut emoji was okay for the bagel emoji. But I do have an important question about the donut emoji. Now, I read that WhatsApp's donut emoji has strawberry frosting. So I'm wondering why anyone would still use WhatsApp if this is true.
Wow. Yeah, good point. I wholeheartedly agree. You know what? So what's fun about WhatsApp is that they have an emoji set that I believe it's mostly designed to sort of work around on Android. They used to use Apple's own emoji set, and now they've designed their own. And they want it to look, it looks a lot like Apple's, but every single emoji, they make one different decision. So you've got a frying pan that has one egg on iOS, and on WhatsApp it has two eggs. You've got the tongue might face this way on iOS, and on WhatsApp it'll face this way. So I guess they decided with the donut, even though everyone has the chocolate donut, they went strawberry. No good.
I love that you're an expert on emoji. It just brings a smile to my face because I have questions.
I do too. Yeah. I have questions beyond the bagel. You go first.
I've got a whole list of food that people had issues with the paella before. Now people are
paella. Like, tell us a little bit about that. Yeah. What was wrong with the paella? Isn't all types of paella
traditionally enough? It had shrimps and things, and the Valencians where paella came from, they don't do that in their meal. They put rabbit. They put chicken. They put beans. So Apple changed that last year without as much fanfare, I've got to say, that they sort of did it a bit under the radar. And now I'm hearing from prominent Mac commentator Federico Vitici. He's quite frustrated that the pizza emoji is very Anglo-centric, very American. It's got the pepperoni. He's from Italy and they have the basil on there and no pepperoni. So you're always going to have some kind of contention about what is the true iconic version of any emoji.
I'm with Federico because I don't eat red meat. And so, I mean, just think of what we could do for the environment if we took away the pepperoni from the pizza emoji. We could change the world.
I'm conceptually on board, but can you imagine the outcry? If you take that pepperoni off that pizza, I think we're going to, my inbox will melt down.
Again, we just need different type of pizzas. Will there ever be a day where every single word that we type into a field is then replaced with an emoji? Like entire sentences? Like, I know we can kind of make that happen now, but I'm talking like type in English and then suddenly it gets converted and every single word is represented by some picture.
We are getting closer. And you know what? I think there could be a tipping point. I have some concern that we could hit a tipping point where we have so many objects and things encoded as emoji that then it's the exception when they're not. And then you feel like you have to encode everything.
Yeah.
So there are actually some issues there. It's one thing if you just say, look, we've only got a small number of emoji. There's 2,000 or so, 2,800 now. If you suddenly have 5,000, you actually get to the point where you could credibly make an argument that every type of vegetable or every fruit or every object has an emoji except this one. So I think there is some, you've got to be a bit cautious about actually adding too many in one go, or we could end up with that scenario where Unicode might feel obliged to add everything.
Well, that brings me to my next question. We chatted a bit on Twitter over this. I noticed there was no cheerleader emoji, and that upset me. And you were where I turned, of course. And you suggested the megaphone, which I think means you're yelling at someone. I was never a cheerleader. I got kicked off the pep squad in seventh grade, so I couldn't try out for cheerleader. But I consider myself, like, metaphorically a cheerleader for people. Like, I like to cheer people on, and I want to be able to do that in emoji. But, you know, someone chimed in on our Twitter conversation saying, like, cheerleading is sort of sexist. But, I mean, it doesn't have to be a female cheerleader. It could be a male cheerleader. Do you think, because I'm thinking I'm going to start the proposal, like, what's my first step? And should I not do this? Because then I would be tipping the scales toward everything needs an emoji.
You know what? I do think people are helpful emoji characters to have, smileys and people. I think the issue is maybe somewhere in the objects where you start getting odd things, like we had an abacus added this year and there's a magnet. And there are some edge cases where you might find them helpful, but some of these I'm not that convinced by. But the cheerleader, let's say you wanted to put in a proposal for that. Mm-hmm. One factor that works slightly against you is that humans do end up at least with a man and a woman version with all the skin tones. And vendors are, well, they're less likely. It costs them more to put that in their OS. It actually takes more memory per emoji. So any emoji that's a human is sort of has to meet a slightly higher benchmark than the rest of them. But nonetheless, if the statistics were good, I haven't looked at it, but hypothetically, if you compared cheerleading to tennis, or maybe I think Unicode used bowling as the median emoji for the sport to say bowling is about in the middle. of all the emoji sports. Let's say cheerleading is more popular than that. If you search it on Instagram, on YouTube, on Google Trends, there is a reasonable chance that it would get up.
What, who uses the lotion emoji? Like, that's the one.
Yeah, that started as a proposal sort of for sunscreen or some kind of sun lotion.
Okay.
But what often happens with these is they start as one thing, and Unicode don't like specific emoji options, so they like to generalize. So this is somewhat of a generalized, it could be some kind of sun lotion or sunscreen. It could be moisturizer. In the end, honestly, it's probably just going to be used in a creepy way by men on Instagram, and I feel bad about that for the women of the world primarily. But yeah, you do get some of these, and that is the challenge with these objects, right? Mm-hmm. Is can they be used to harass, or are they just innocent and it's just like words and it's however we use them? You can use them in any given way. So that is a bit of an odd one.
Oh, this is the internet. Nothing is innocent. Jeremy, I have to imagine you have a list. You probably keep a list, keep it on your phone of the thing that you most want turn into an emoji, and then when it's done, when it's turned into an emoji, you're like, yay, and you check it off, and then you go to down the list. I'm totally guessing here. What is something that you are holding out for an emoji?
I do have one, but I am a bit concerned about its multiple uses. But I am that annoying person that likes to photograph my breakfast, and I've got the avocado, we've got the bacon, got the fried egg. We don't have any sausage, and I'd really like a sausage, but yeah. I do also think it might not get used as a sausage. Mm-hmm. So I haven't proposed that, but I think it'd be popular. There's a lot of different types of sausages in the world.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of breakfast out there.
How that could be weirdly used.
Yeah.
I think there should be an emoji. I know there's never an emoji of a specific person, but there are emoji of careers. And I think emoji expert emoji, and it would look like you.
Oh. Look like me. Wow.
Or we could get Rick Astley as an emoji. And then we could Rickroll people in emoji.
But that's a person. You can't do that.
I know. Well, I'm just saying the one and only, the one and only person that you would bend the rules for would be Rick Astley. Mm-hmm. That makes sense, right?
Bend the rules for Rick.
Yeah.
You'd have to give it a different name. Like WhatsApp, you mentioned WhatsApp before. They've got the singing emoji. There's the man singer and the woman singer. Mm-hmm. And so in the Unicode spec, they're only called singers, but Apple makes theirs look like David Bowie. WhatsApp makes theirs look like Prince. So there are some clever ways that you can get around. You have a generic code point, but then the vendors can do clever things. So this isn't a David Bowie emoji or a Prince emoji. It's just a singer, but you can do what you like.
Yeah,
so
you
could be creative with the Rick Astley and or the Emoji Expert emoji approval.
Right, because there are no other emoji experts. I mean, no one would be confused by that. I think.
Well,
yeah, that's true.
Unfortunately, I'm the most incredibly generic white dude on the planet, so I might look just like the normal. You see on Twitter, you see a lot of. I see it a lot from more men than women, but everybody uses it where they put it in their bio. They put the person behind the computer in their Twitter in their Twitter name, but. Uh-huh. It kind of looks like everybody, and I think, honestly, if you put a laptop about here on my face, I'm pretty much just the guy behind the laptop already, aren't I?